Hello and good afternoon to everyone. I am Ajay Kumar Pandey and I am going to present my e-poster topic, which is forensic analysis of contaminated soil samples using ATR-FTIR. So as we all know, the soil is one of the most common type of trace evidence that is encountered in the crime like murder, kidnapping, burglary, etc. And most of the time under different circumstances, the traces of biological fluids like blood, semen, or other body fluids may be present in the soil. And as we know that soil is recovered in very small quantities as trace evidence, and then it is not possible to separate the biological fluids from the soil. And that will create the problem in linking the soil with the crime scene. So the objective of this study is to observe the spectral changes of the soil in presence of blood and to observe the spectral changes of contaminated soil on heating. The samples were collected from the Jhansi city, which is situated in Uttar Pradesh state of India. Samples were collected from the three sites, and sites were chosen in triangular manner so that it could represent the overall spectral properties of Jhansi. The samples were then cleaned and dried and cleaned and then grinded manually. And after that, we made partitions of the samples. One partition were kept separate from other partitions, which were labeled as standard samples. And then other partitions were contaminated with blood. The blood was collected from two healthy individuals. And after the contamination, soil samples were subjected to heat to check the effect of heating on the soil samples in presence of blood. So in the analysis portion, I have put the spectral data of which represent the overall spectral properties of the samples from site A, then site B, and then site C. And we can see that as when we put blood in the soil and mix it, we were able to clearly differentiate the peaks that are characteristic for blood that belongs to the amide 1, amide 2, and amide A region that are 1537 centimeter inverse, 1637 centimeter inverse, and 3284 centimeter inverse. These peaks are characteristics for blood, and we were able to differentiate it clearly from the soil samples. And as samples were subjected to heat and as temperature rises 100 degrees centigrade, there was a sudden decrease of IR absorption in the sample as oxyhemoglobin start to changes in the methemoglobin and other biochemical changes start to happen in the blood due to the thermal degradation of blood. And as soon as temperature reaches 200 degrees centigrade, the peaks start to decrease and the peak related to amide A region got missing from the sample. But peaks related to amide 1 and amide 2 regions were present in the samples. And as temperature reaches 300 degrees centigrade, the peak related to amide 1 region also got disappeared from the sample. And there is only amide 2 region that can be identified in the heat samples that were heated on 300 degrees centigrade. And as soon as temperature reaches 400 degrees centigrade, the peaks just got disappeared. And we were totally unable to tell whether the sample was contaminated with biological fluid or not. So the conclusion was that the presence of blood in the soil can be determined till the 200 or 300 degrees centigrade. And after that, the disappearance of peaks suggests that the blood in the soil got charred rapidly. And if some components of blood left on the soil, they got completely dominated by the presence of soil. So the conclusion of my study was that contaminated and heated soil samples showed the presence of amide 1, amide 2, and amide A regions, which clearly shows the presence of blood in samples. And the identification of blood in these samples will totally depend on the quantity of blood that is present on the soil and the time period for which the blood was present in the soil. Because the microbial communities present in the soil will play a major role, and they will degrade the blood sample. And after a certain time, we will not be able to tell the we will not be able to tell whether the sample was contaminated with whether the sample was contaminated with soil or not. And this study shows that the ATR-FTIR is a significant analytical tool for the analysis of soil samples that are contaminated with blood or any other biological fluid. And with these words, I want to end my presentation. Thank you.